I've been given the topic of success stories in Muslim girls' education and empowerment. As you can see that I am an MBBS and MD. I want to check this, but it still didn't work. It half is getting cut, no problem. From this country, in a government medical college, God made me a doctor. And after being content with my career, I wanted to give my own contribution. We all know that illiteracy among Muslim girls is a crisis. So many committee reports, we all know that. And when I wanted to give back something, I felt that the best thing is to educate the girl child. And especially since the morning we have been discussing about the Muslim girl child. And therefore, Al Momina School was born. An English medium school for girls established in 2000 with just 9 girls in the nursery and 9 girls in the junior KG. And that was a time probably when Jyoti had come over and visited that small place, 2 small rooms to be called a school. But that's how it started. And my younger daughter was part of the experiment. Normally what happens is teachers, principals, they run schools, but their own children are in some other schools. That means they don't have faith in their own school. It speaks a lot. Like we had the earlier speakers also saying that my child is in my school. So therefore this experiment, I had no place. So my daughter was also there. Then next, with the very next academic year, there were 100 girls. Now what were the challenges for Al Momina? No proper location because it was a rented place. We were asked to leave even that rented place in just 1.5 years. No proper infrastructure, no playground. However, yet, we changed 4 places. A school changing places is unimaginable. I mean, how can parents ever, bear that? Why? How can we change places? In fact, there was one parent who was also on leave and license basis. He would ask me, "Amma, where is the school going to shift so that I can rent a house near the school?" So what is it that made the school enrollment grow? Probably because the quality of English medium education. It's an only girls' school, very important for the Muslims. And only girls' schools. The uniform is in accordance with the Islamic guidelines. And in the school itself, we teach them to read and understand the Quran so that the girls don't have to go to the madrasa. Because for Muslims, it is mandatory for them to teach Quran to their children. So if we provide this education right in the school itself, then they feel that, okay, even if they wanted only Arabic education for their children, now here they're simultaneously getting English medium education also. So after 14 years, we have more than 1,000 girls. The standard 8, 9 and 10 have been recognized by the government. It is very surprising that the recognition norms for secondary schools are much easier as compared to fulfill as compared to a primary school. The primary school norms very difficult to fulfill, especially under the Bombay Municipal Corporation. Not possible to fulfill. Our school is on a lease, in a lease building. We don't have a 33-year lease, so they won't give us recognition. And we've been having consistently since the last 6 years, 100% results, and the highest percentage has been more than 92. Now, branches of Al Momina have also started, even though we don't have our own premises in the first school itself. But how it started was that one parent wanted to send her child from Khargar to our school. So far, so she was a real estate agent, this lady. She told me that I will ask help from some builders and I'll do this and I'll do that and, you know, Sitco will give you a plot and all that, she said. And poor thing, she tried to help out. She got a place on rent and that's how the school started there. Then in Surat, the school started because relatives were staying there in Surat. They wanted a similar school in Surat. And therefore, again, in a rented place, the school started there. And Mira Road, again, when people started shifting from Bombay to Mira Road, they wanted a similar school there. So we have now 3 more branches. People from Muslims, especially from Kashmir to Tamil Nadu, want to start schools on a similar pattern. And they contact me. And because it's not feasible for me to monitor so many schools, I give them whatever expertise I have and I share my syllabus, my timetable, my curriculum, etc. with them. What is the need of Muslim parents today? They want an only girls' school with a safe and secure Islamic environment. If we want to increase literacy amongst women, amongst girls, Muslim girls, we have to have schools which are only girls, a safe and secure environment. Some people may have a problem about, only girls' school, why not co-ed? They can visit a site called singlesexschools.org and they may learn from there that girls and boys learn differently. So if you teach them, if you separately teach them, it's better for them. And this is not an Islamic website or anything. It's an American website, singlesexschools.org. Then that school should be providing quality English medium education. The uniform also of the school should be according to Islamic guidelines, which is very important. Why? Because in certain schools, the girls are told to remove their scarves, their pajamas, and they don't want to continue studies there. So why not provide them the dress which they want? Because what do we want? We want to provide them education. So why can't we provide them, if they're wearing a scarf or if they're wearing a shalwar, does it matter to us when we are providing education? I don't think so. And if we have Quranic studies as a part of the syllabus for the Muslim girls, I'm sure our enrollment will increase. And I would like to share with you an article which was published in the Times of India, dated 24th August 2014. It says that in a revealing instance of social dynamics in a pluralistic society like Kerala, a growing number of schools run by non-Muslim managements are allowing Muslim girl students to wear the headscarf from class 1 onwards. The permission for wearing scarves from class 1 follows other special measures like the introduction of Islamic studies and Quran classes and arrangements for Friday prayers by these private schools. So you see, even non-Muslim managements are giving these to the Muslim children if they want enrollment, if they want the Muslim children to be educated. The article continues, some school authorities are candid enough to admit that this is being done to woo the Muslim students. Schools in areas where Muslims are dominant are keen to please parents and ensure students' strength. They fear that if they don't allow children to wear scarves from class 1 or don't introduce Quran or Islamic studies, then parents would be reluctant to send their children to school. So this is one point which is extremely important to note, that if we want increased enrollment of Muslim girls, then the Islamic dress code has to be thought about. And I'll show you a very small clip. I've actually edited it so that I don't take much of your time, where a girl who took admission in our school is saying why she took admission in our school. Now, the next thing is, we are worried. Why? Some people worry that can these girls adjust to society after passing out from such schools where it's only girls, where they're wearing the Islamic dress? Will they be able to mix with the society? So my experience, where 6 batches have passed out, depending on the percentages they have secured, suppose somebody's got 93 or 94%, she's got admission in KC College or Jai Hind, one of the elite colleges of South Mumbai, and they've taken admission in any college, all across. And because they were so confident about themselves, they are very easily adjusting to the environment. There's no problem whatsoever. Even though they're going to a co-ed environment, with their burqa, and you'll be very surprised, and even I was shocked when one of my students recently told me, just a couple of days ago, she told me that she's finished her bachelor's in arts, and she told me that she's joined a journalism course in the University of Mumbai, and in this journalism course, she's the only Muslim student, not even girl or a boy, she's the only Muslim student, and she wears the niqab, where she covers her face also, only her eyes are seen. I don't know that, so I asked her, do you sit in the class with the niqab? She said, yes. And she's interacting with everybody because she wants to develop her writing skills. Why has she joined this journalism course? Because she wants to develop her writing skills. And she's sitting with a niqab because she's confident. She's well grounded. She has no problem whatsoever. And she's interacting with everybody. And they're talking about, you know, different things they are discussing, like homosexuality, like, Article 377 and everything, you know. She's able to discuss. So what... Some Muslims fear that if the child is sent to such an environment, then the child will not be able to adjust to a pluralistic society. So here we have an example that it's possible. and they are. Why? Because they're confident. They've been given those skills in a safe and a secure environment where they are not humiliated. I'm a product of very prestigious schools throughout the north of the country because my father had a transferable job, and I'm very sorry, I don't want to hurt anybody's feelings, but I was humiliated in school because I was a Muslim. My daughter, my elder daughter who studied in an elite school of Bombay, was also humiliated in school. So we grow up with complexes. How can we contribute to the society, to the nation, when we are complexed? You know, we cannot. We have to be, you know, we have to be given that confidence. When we have that confidence, then inshallah we can contribute to the society. We can be a good citizen of the country, and therefore only we can contribute to the society. So it's extremely important, those formative years, that Muslim girls are educated in an environment they are comfortable with. Extremely important. Recently, just 8 days back, one lady, and I've been wanting to contact Jyoti, I hope she's here, to please let people know that this lady whose three girls were going to an elite convent school of Mumbai was humiliated because one of the child was very sick, had typhoid, could not attend school for a couple of days, so she produced a certificate, okay? And they said, you go to your community schools, and she was chucked. You know, humiliated. And this lady is she speaks fluent English. She wears a burqa, but she speaks fluent English. So she came to us, and this is already at the end of the first term. Please give us admission. I have no place in the school because I have very small rooms. So, but then I had to, I mean, where will this lady go with three girls? So I have to put an extra chair. Somehow I have to fit in, you know, adjust. And I think people should know about it, that this is what is happening. We talk about education and empowerment of the Muslim girl. And if this is going to happen, how is she going to be empowered? So, in the formative years, educated in an environment they're comfortable with, then they will develop the confidence. And then they will contribute positively to the society, inshallah. These girls are tomorrow's mothers. Their well-being, mental, social, and physical, is absolutely essential. Because they are going to raise the next generation, which will contribute to the growth of our nation. I just want to show you a small clip about the school, and that's the end of my presentation. I probably haven't taken 15 minutes as yet also, which I promised.
Modernization of madrasas in Islamic education has had many stumbling blocks. There has been resistance as well in some quarters. But now we have for you a success story in one of the most modern cities in the country, Mumbai, where students are learning to chant A for Allah as readily as they once said Alif for Allah. Headlines today's Manoj Tripathi. Blocks. There has been resistance as well in some quarters, but now we have for you a success story in one of the most modern cities in the country, Mumbai, where students are learning to chant A for Allah as readily as they once said Alif for Allah. Headlines today's Manoj Tripathi reports.
English speaking, academically on par with the best, and thoroughly Islamic in conduct and appearance. This Islamic English school in Mumbai aims to produce a radically different generation of Muslims, all by combining Islam with regular academic curriculum. Many a mainstream schools may have failed to meet the complex needs of today's Muslims. But it is schools like these with perfect mix of modernity and traditionalism that have given a new lease of life to the Generation Next Muslim population. With Manoj Tripathi in Mumbai, Tripti Jain, Headlines Today.
Now from the primary class students, let's now progress to the senior girls of the school. Keeping in pace with the need of the times, senior girls in the school are imparted education on varied subjects. So whether it's computer science or martial arts or even sex education, the girls here know it all.
Well, this is the conventional image of any traditional Islamic school. But now, take a look at this. Girls of Al Mumina Islamic School are being imparted self-defense classes. From judo to karate, these girls are trained on how to defend themselves in any situation.
Learning the practice karate to protect ourselves, to be physically healthy, and to protect ourselves from enemies.
However, it's not only about self-defense education. The girls here are also armed with the skills of the latest technology like their contemporaries. Pupils a chance to pursue their aspirations while simultaneously keeping them grounded to their roots.
जब बड़ी होंगी तो मुझे एक डॉक्टर बनना है।
I will grow up. I want to become an architect.
What is more astonishing is that this Islamic school teaches Marathi. Taking a step further, the school has also made it a point to sensitize young girls about HIV and sex education. With Manish Tripathi in Mumbai, Shipra Vadwa, Headlines Today.
Schools may be new in India, it is gradually becoming popular. Each passing day sees more and more Muslim students quitting convent schools to pursue studies here. Here's a report by our correspondent, Manish Tripathi.
Meet Maryam Sheikh. A student of class 9, Maryam has been to both an Islamic and convent school. Before getting herself enrolled in Al Mumina Islamic School, Maryam studied at a Mumbai convent school till class 6. But soon she left the school to seek admission here as she found the education and the norms of the convent violating her religion.
Actually, in a convent school, we were forced to read rosaries, which was totally un-Islamic, and we, as we Muslim students, we would wear our hijab and shalwar. They would tell us to remove our hijabs and shalwar out of the gate.
Ask her whether she has any qualms about the decision, Maryam assertively says no. And the reason behind this confident response is not that the school allows her to preach her religion, but a free will that an individual is allowed here. In fact, wearing a burqa or veil in Al Mumina Islamic School is not compulsory. The school allows the students to decide for themselves. Maryam is so impressed with this flexible mode of education that she even advises her friends, both Muslims and non-Muslims, to experience the teaching here.
Quite a far. Thanks a lot for joining us. Right now we're taking a short break on Headlines Today. But
thank you very much for listening.